Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you. Today, as you know, everywhere in the United Kingdom at the moment, whether you go to Manchester, London, and last month, if you went to Scotland, you'll find such billboards where the Ahmadiyya Muslim community is promoting this campaign, Messiah Has Come, or the Messiah Has Come. We are Ahmadi Muslims. Of course, I'm now, at the moment, first of all, I'm looking to both cameras for the Periscope as well as Facebook Live. In this case, let's go back. We are Muslims, Ahmadi Muslims, to make it clear for everyone, for every Muslim as well as a non-Muslim. We are Muslims who believe exactly as other Muslims believe. Moreover, we believe that the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the Khatam al-Nabiyyin, or he's the seal of the prophets. The seal of the prophets. We also believe that anyone who does not believe in the Khatam al-Nabuwa, or in English, the seal of prophethood, that the Holy Prophet is the seal of prophets, we consider him as a non-Muslim. We also believe that those prophecies which had to be fulfilled, those prophecies which are related to the reformer of the age, to the messenger of the age, who will be raised to reform mankind, we believe that he has come. That is why you find all these billboards, the Messiah has come. We want to give you the glad tidings that the Messiah has come. And we believe that Mirza Ghulam Ahmed of Qadian, His Holiness, that he is the promised Messiah and the Imam Mahdi. He's the one who has been prophesied by the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and he's the one who has been prophesied by all prophets. In reality, if I go back to the Holy Quran, let's go back to the foundation. Allah says in Surah Ali Imran, or chapter Ali Imran, and God says, verse 65 in Arabic, قُلْ يَا أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْا إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ أَلَّا تَعْبُدَ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَلَا تُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا. Say, O people of the book, come to a common word, or to a word equal between us and you, that we worship none but Allah, and that we associate no partner with him, and that some of us take not others for lords beside Allah. The common word is here, I speak now to Christians, to those who are followers of Judaism, and any other religion, including the Muslims. The Quran says here that let's come to a common thing. What is the common thing between all those religions, the revealed religions? The common thing is that we all believe in the one God, whether he's called Father, or he's called Allah, whatever his name. We believe that the God who revealed himself to the Holy Prophet Muhammad is the same God who revealed himself to Jesus, and who himself revealed himself to Moses, Abraham, and all other prophets. All the prophets in the world. No nation in the world has been deprived of prophethood. Now, if all these nations, or all these people, all their religions are revealed by the one and the same God, how can we say then that religions are contradicting each other? That is why Quran says, let's come to common word. If we go back to Christianity, we will find Christianity, the revelation of it. Jesus got this revelation from God, the Gospels. Same with the Torah, or the Old Testament, has been revealed by Allah to Moses, Judaism and Christianity. All of them, all of these religions, had the commandment that we worship Allah, or we worship God in this sense, and we have to give the due rights to mankind, to the creation. These are two most fundamental elements of any religion. Love God and love thy neighbor, or love your brother. You should have that love for your brother. You should love for him all what you love for yourself. Now, if this is the case, then what is the difference between the religion which has been brought by the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and Jesus and other prophets? The only difference is that Allah, the Holy Quran, makes it clear. It says, Al-Yawma Akmaltu Lakum Dinakum Wa Atmamtu Alaykum Ni'mati Wa Raditu Lakum Al-Islama Dina, which means, today I have completed your religion and I have perfected my favor unto you, and I have selected or chosen Islam as your religion. That means from the beginning, when God created mankind, there was only one religion, as there is one God and there is one mankind. That religion was called Islam. The Islam has found its perfection in the religion brought by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him. That means prophethood found its climax in the Holy Prophet Muhammad. A spiritual evolution took place, and its peak has been realized by the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Religion found its climax also in the religion brought by Muhammad, peace be upon him, which is called Islam. All the books before the Holy Quran now have found their climax in the Holy Quran. That which this makes the Holy Quran the seal of all books, the mother of all books, the Holy Prophet, the father of all prophets, or the seal of the prophets. And Islam is culmination of all religions, the summit of all religions. That is why the Messiah who had been expected, who has been expected by all religions, every prophet prophesied that someone will come at the end of times as a reformer of the age, at the end of times. The Holy Prophet mentioned his own words. He said, if I read it, عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يوشك من عاش منكم أن يلقى عيسى بن مريم إماما مهديا وحكما عدلا فيكسر الصليب ويقتل الخنزير ويدع الجزية وتضع الحرب أوزارها. أبو هريرة says that the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, it's just possible that he who lives among you might meet Jesus, the son of Mary, who will be in the same time himself the Mahdi and a just judge. He will break the cross, kill the swine, and will make an end to the jizya, the poll tax. These are the prophecies which we find in the narrations of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. That means at the end of the times, someone will be there. Now, will it Jesus himself who will appear? Is it Jesus himself? This is the question. Why does the Holy Prophet refer to Jesus? Why does Jesus himself, when he spoke about the future, when he made that prophecy that he will come back, he also referred to himself? To understand that, let's look into depth, understand these things in depth. When the Jewish at the time of Jesus, they were waiting for the Messiah, there they were waiting at the same time for a forerunner, Elijah, who had to descend from the heavens. And so it happened that Jesus told them, in my own words, accept it or do not accept it. It's John the Baptist who came in the likeness of Elijah, Prophet Elijah. Those who are waiting for him for as mentioned in the book of Malachi, that Elijah will descend, Jesus made it clear. Elijah passed away. Like all other prophets, they're human beings. And John the Baptist came as the forerunner, and he came into his likeness. So it's very clear. The Holy Quran mentioned very clear, and Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmed, the promised Messiah and Imam Mahdi, God revealed to him in 1891. Remember, this is my own words. Jesus, the son of Mary, the messenger of God, passed away. And it is you who came into his spirit. Now, Quran makes it very clear. If you go in depth, and the point is, when is there a time scale? Did the Holy Quran or the Bible spoke about that time, the signs, the need of time? Was there, as we believe, that Mirza Ghulam Ahmed of Qadian, peace be upon him, he appeared in the 19th century, born in 1835, founded the Ahmadiyya community in 1889, claimed to the Messiah to be the Messiah and Mahdi 1891. All of this in the 19th century. Do we find something back? We know from the Holy Quran, very clearly, and God makes it very clear to the Muslims in the Holy Quran, in chapter 32, he says, يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ ثُمَّ يَعْرُجُ إِلَيْهِ فِي يَوْمٍ كَانَ مِقْدَارَهُ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ مِمَّا تَعُدُّونَ. I try to find the reference here for you and to read it out. It says, يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ ثم يعرج إليه في يوم كان مقداره ألف سنة مما تعدون ذلك عالم الغيب والشهادة العزيز الرحيم. God says in the Holy Quran, it is he who sends the command from the heavens to the earth, and it will surely go back to him, it will return in one day, and that is according to your calculation, it will be 1,000 years. And remember, the Holy Prophet made it very clear that his age will be the best age, his century. The century after that, وَالْقَرْنِ الَّذِي يَلُونَهُمْ, and the century after that, 300 years, plus 1,000 years of darkness, in which the Muslims, unfortunately, will flourish, but they will not flourish as they flourished before and prosper. In this case, it makes it 14th century, 1,300 years. Let's go to the Bible. For those Christians who are not familiar with the Holy Quran, I want to focus also on the Bible itself. Now, this episode is on Facebook Live, through Instagram Periscope. Remember, there will be many series coming. It's very important to accept the Messiah. Today, His Holiness, the Caliph, the successor of the promised Messiah, spoke about the unity of God and mentioned a certain chapter in the Holy Quran which speaks about the unity of God, and that in reality, prophets are only here to prove and to bring us from darkness into light, and to show us that God exists. Prophets show us, any Messiah shows us, that there is not, according to mathematical calculation or physics, that we should ponder and then come to a maximum, maximize everything, the conclusion, and come to the conclusion there should be a God. A prophet comes, the messenger comes to tell us there is God. He shows his heavenly signs and earthly signs. In this case, a prophet is like the moon, is like the sun, better to say, in the night. And in that darkness, the people are not able in spirit to see God, to observe the existence, to observe God and to be convinced of his existence. But that moon will be enlightened through that spiritual sun and that spiritual son is a prophet or messenger of God. I will explain. And it says in the Bible, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. Matthew 24:14. Which means that the Bible, the gospel, will spread all over the world before the coming of that Messiah. I can tell you, and this is very interesting, according to the British Foreign Bible Society and according to the American Bible Society, especially in 1804, in 1816, they made a very strong claim. They said that in the 19th century, by 1800, sorry, they mentioned it very clearly, that by 1816, in the beginning 19th century, that 421 million copies of the Bible were distributed among all nations in the world. Christianity had been spread all over the world. That was in the 19th century. I will go back to the proofs from the Quran and also from the Bible, for the Jewish and for the Christians. Let me go to certain question. Does Quran mention about dinosaurs? It's a very nice question about dinosaurs, but it's not important at the moment. It's not relevant. Very good question, but inshallah, in the next episodes, when I deem it appropriate, I will respond to this question. Because today we are not speaking about the relevance of, you see, we are not speaking about prophecies in the Holy Quran, about some important matters mentioned in the Quran in relation to ancient history. We are speaking about the Messiah. The Messiah is important because the Messiah is the one who is awaited by all people to revive mankind, to get people out of this materialism, to make people control their desires, making people, instead of making them the worms of the earth, making them birds flying into the spirit, in the spiritual heaven. Before I continue again, there is a question. There is a hadith, when the Messiah will come, there will be no wars. Absolutely. And this question, of course, is relevant. When the Messiah will come, there will be no wars, because this has been mentioned by the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He mentioned very clear, there will be an end. He will make end to these religious wars. That's why he is a Messiah who will come like Jesus, to put that tolerance, that compassion, that love in the hearts of the Muslims. He will reunite the Muslims under the banner of the spiritual caliphate. He will be the one who will unite the Muslims, and he will be the one who will bring all the non-Muslims into the fold of Islam to spread tolerance, compassion, love, harmony, brotherhood, compassion. If I go further, and then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, Matthew 24:30. And then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. You know, why will people wail? Why will the people start to beat, you know, on their chests? Why shall the people start to cry? Why does it mention? Because unfortunately, Jesus mentioned very clear, that's a prophecy, that his personality, somehow people will exaggerate his status. Some people, like among the Christians, will make him a kind of God, that he died on the cross, then he revived from the death, then he himself got all the powers of God, and he's sitting beside God in the heavens. Then we have the Muslims, who unfortunately at that time will be so far from the true teachings of Islam that the Holy Prophet mentioned that they're scholars, spiritual scholars, they're religious scholars. You will knock on the door, you will go to them, you will find them like swines and monkeys, which means they will be only imitating Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, only imitating him physically, imitating him just not in the spiritual sense, but only in physical or in literal sense. The Holy Prophet had a beard, they will have a beard. He had a turban, they will have a turban. Their spirit, they will be devoid of all spirit. Then it is they also who are unfortunately influenced by Christianity, by believing that Jesus is in the heaven, or even Prophet Muhammad, the great prophet, passed away, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him. And they believe that he's in the heavens. They give him, they attributed to him some extraordinary powers. Then we have our Jewish people who say that in reality, it's not like that. Jesus died on the cross. In reality, Jesus died a cursed death. Jesus, in reality, was a false prophet because he died on the cross. And that is why it says at that time, the people start to wail, because the reality will be shown through the promised Messiah. He will show them Jesus, the son of Mary, was just a human being. Our nature, our rationale believes. If I tell you, do you know my great, great, great grandfather 1,000 years ago is in the heavens? You will not believe me, because it's against your nature. And fitratullah allati fatara an-nasa alayha. Islam is made according to your nature, or your nature is according to Islam. Now, in this case, Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad of Qadian, the Prophet Messiah Mahdi, peace be upon him, he is the one who proved from the Holy Quran at least 30 times that Jesus, son of Mary, wasn't great noble prophet, but a human being. And he passed away, like all prophets passed away. I will read something from the Holy Quran. مَلْ مَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمْ إِلَّا الرَّسُولِ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرَّسُولِ وَأُمُّهُ صَدِّيقًا كَانَ يَأْكُلَانِ الطَّعَامِ. Jesus, the son of Mary, the Messiah, the son of Mary, was just a messenger of God. Indeed, all prophets before him passed away. His mother was a truthful woman. I translate just in my own words. كَانَ يَأْكُلَانِ الطَّعَامِ. Are you not using your mind? Are you not aware? How can you, Allah says here, say that they are alive? Don't you see they were used to have food, which means they are not eating anymore. Kana, they were used to eating food. Now, what we want to say here in depth, Muhammad, we do not believe as Ahmadi Muslims that Jesus, the son of Mary, will come back. Why? Number one, very simple. Because the Quran mentioned very clear that he's dead. And all the ahadith, inshallah, by God's grace, in the next episodes, I will bring all those narrations from the ahadith. Now, and the Holy Quran, number one, that he died. Secondly, we do not believe that Jesus will come back. The answer is very simple. Because Muhammad is the seal of the prophets. And as a seal of the prophets, it's impossible that any prophet after him will come. Only the one who is a follower of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, because Quran is complete. Allah says, "Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas." You are the best nation brought among mankind, raised among mankind. And Muslims do not need any. The question is only, do Muslims need a reformer? If the Muslims need a reformer, why should that need be fulfilled by a previous old prophet? Is Allah not able to fulfill that need by making a Muslim as a prophet? Why? Those who say Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is last prophet among the Sunni or Shia Muslims, one question to them then: how can you say then that Jesus will come after him? If you tell him he will not come as a prophet, you degrade him. Moreover, this is against the Holy Quran and against the Ahadith. He will be a prophet. And secondly, if you say he will come as a prophet, then this is against the seal of prophethood. Because after Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, according to our belief, a prophet can only come as a follower of Sharia of Islam. And according to the Sunnah and the Shia, he will come as a prophet after Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, whether someone was a prophet before Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it does not prevent him to be a prophet after Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he comes. It doesn't deny the fact that he will be a prophet after Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then how do we explain Rasulan ila Bani Israel? He will be a prophet. He will be a prophet for the children of Israel. Ya Bani Israel, inni Rasulullah ilaykum. I am a prophet sent to you, to the children of Israel. Allah taught him the Torah and the Injil. Word, will the Holy Quran will that be revealed to him? Let's go back. Now, if we read again in the Bible, then Jesus says, when ye therefore shall see the abominations of desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet, stand up in the holy place. Matthew 24:15. Then it says, let's go back, what is written in Daniel? It says 70 weeks are determined upon thy people and upon the holy city to finish the transgression and to make an end of sins and to make a reconciliation for iniquity and to bring in everlasting righteousness and to seal up the vision and prophecy and to anoint the most holy. What does it mean? You know, it was Daniel who prayed and was fasting and supplicated, oh God, when are you going to restore the children of Israel? When are you going to restore the temple? When will be this temple be rebuilt? And God told him 70 weeks. And it is very clear in the Bible, I don't want to go in depth, that one day, one span is equal to one year to one year. Now, 70 weeks is equal to 70 times 7, of course, 490 days, which is equal to 490 years. And that was exactly the time. I am telling you, and this is a very important phenomenon, that when that has been rebuilt, the Temple of Jerusalem, okay, that we can say, if we check it and we say 450, if we check the history, we find that the third decree was 457 before Christ for rebuilding, that the temple had been rebuilt. And it has been said that 70 weeks it will take and the vision, the revelations of God will come to an end. And that was exactly to 33 after Christ. And that was when Jesus had been appointed as a prophet and a Messiah. And that was the time when God, there was no prophet anymore among the Jewish. No prophet appeared except the Holy Prophet Muhammad. Then we go deep in there. Then it says, Daniel asked, this is very interesting. Daniel spoke about the second coming of Christ. And he said, then I heard one saint speaking. And one another said unto that certain saint which spoke, how long shall be the vision concerning the daily sacrifice and how long the transgression of desolation, to give both sanctuary and the host to be trodden underfoot? And he said, unto 2,300 days, which means then shall be the sanctuary be cleansed. And it's exactly 2,300 days from the rebuilding of the temple, and that is equally to 1843, the 19th century again. Now, I'm not going Mirza Ghulam. Ahmed of Qadian was born in 1835 and 33. Prophethood is, at, according to Quran, 40 years. And even about the birth of Jesus, that there was a margin of 7 to 9 years. If you calculate it, it doesn't matter. It's exactly the 19th century. That means the Holy Quran, the Hadith, the Bible, the Old Testament, the New Testament, all of them say the 19th century will be the time when Jesus will come. The question here, there is another question. Let's go for this question. There can never be a prophet after the last messenger, Muhammad Sassim, has arrived. My dear brother, when you make any statement, Allah mentioned in the Quran, فَرُدُّهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ. You should always go back to Allah and His Prophet. You see, when in this age, we have so many groups and so many sects, Muhammad Sassim had been asked about it. He said, فَاعْتَزِلْ, you should get rid and remove, differentiate yourself from all those firqa, all the sects. You have to go, even if you have to go to the jungle and to live there, only by eating the leaves of a tree until you die. فَاعْتَزِلْ تِلْكَ الْفِرْقَ كُلَّهِ, the Holy Prophet said. Read the Ahadith. Now, we say it is not the Ahmadiyya Muslim community who says there is a prophet after Muslim the way that unfortunately many religious scholars believe. We say Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and I will speak in depth about Khatm al-Nabuwa. There will be no prophet after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, no new nor old. After the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, any prophet who will appear within the Ummah. He will be a Muslim. He will be a follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The difference is, what is the interpretation of Nabuwa? Al-Quran, Surat Al-Muzammil, makes it very clear. لا يظهر على غيبه أحد إلا من ارتدى من رسول. لا يظهر على غيبه أحد إلا من ارتدى من رسول. Which means that the abundance, the inquanted revelation of the unseen in quality and quantity will not be revealed except to the one who is appointed as a Nabi or Rasul in this case. Which means a Rasul means, a prophet means the one who receives the in quality, high quality and quantity and high frequency revelations of the unseen in order to unite the people and to show them God exists and in order to convince them. Now we Ahmadis believe that Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmed, peace be upon him, was a Muslim. And he is the one of follower of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now I have a question to you, my brother, who asked this question. It is you who believe that Jesus will come back. When you believe that Jesus will come back, Allah said he's Rasul ila Bani Israel. Where did he learn the Holy Quran? Can you show me one verse in the Holy Quran where it has been mentioned that Jesus is alive? Allah said, I taught him the Torah and the Injil. Where did he learn the Holy Quran? When Jesus will come back, he will be a prophet. This is, I will explain this in depth. Allah says in the Holy Quran, before this, let me go to another question. Are there any Shia hadiths which supports Prince Messiah? Okay. Yes, the Shia, as well as the Sunnis, as well as all followers in the world of any religion, believe that the Messiah has to come. Denial of the Messiah has its own spiritual consequences, is in reality denial of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and denial of Allah himself. I will go into this. Why is the term descend used in reference to the second coming of Jesus? Nazala ينزل. It has been used in the Quran not only to Jesus. I will read something out for you, very, very interesting, in the Holy Quran. Allah says in the Holy Quran, first of all, Allah says that I sent down the iron. Allah says, that I sent down the an'am. The an'am means here the cattle. Do you think that the cattle came from the heaven? Then Allah says in the Holy Quran, I sent down the clothes. Allah sent the libas. Now read the Holy Quran in depth. You will find Allah nazal hadid, Allah nazal libas, Allah nazal an'am. Doesn't mean that did we see the cows coming from the heavens? Did we see the iron coming from the heavens? Did we see the clothes coming from the heavens? You know, the word nazala has been used in connection to prophets. This is a spiritual meaning, which means that people like the prophets Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Isa, and others, they reached such a high level that when they reached that level where Allah was so pleased with them and appointed them as messengers, then Allah metaphorically told them, now you descend down. Inzil, you go down. This is what is meant in the Holy Quran by Nazala. Like, another example. Yeah, some people say Jesus revived the dead. Allah says about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu istajibu lillahi wa lirrasul. Idha da'akum lima yuhyikum. Allah says, listen, you see, obey the Holy Prophet, Allah. Stajibu lillah. Listen, respond, obey to Allah and His Messenger when He calls unto you, so that He will give you life. Yuhyikum. Allah al-Rasul yuhyikum. What does it mean, Allah al-Rasul yuhyikum? He will revive you from your death, spiritual death. My dear brother, the Holy Quran is one, as one building, is one structure. Remove one brick, everything will go down. No verse is contradicting other verse. Now, let's go now, continue the subject of the Messiah has come. Before that, because there are two cameras here, sometimes I'm looking to the Facebook camera, I have to also look to the Periscope one. Someone asked me, why do you call yourselves Muslims? Are you not declared kafir? You see, this is what I try to tell you. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the Holy Quran and in the Ahadith, a time will come, nothing will la yabqa min al-Islam illa ismu. Nothing will be left of Islam except its name. The Quran, just its word. The people go to the mosque, mosque will be built, but they will be devoid of guidance. Then he said, "Ulama'ahum sharrun min tahtadim as-sama', min 'indahum takhruj al-fitnah wa ilayhim ta'ud." Their scholars will be the worst people under the canopy of heavens, and all the evil plots they are there trying, you know, to plan, to make, to do, it will return to them, back to them. Now, who is the one who makes me? Let's speak about myself. Muhammad Ibrahim Ikhlaf. I'm of Arab origin, from Morocco. Just introduce myself. I joined this Ahmadi community in the 90s. And I joined this community after I am convinced 100% according to the Holy Quran that this is the truth and Ahmadiyya is the truth. Why? Now, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when we check him, he said very clear that the one who says La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, is a Muslim. In that sense, in my heart, I believe, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Is there anyone who can declare me as a kafir? Now, if we are going into this field, we find so many groups among Sunnis declared each other as kafir. Who is then left as a Muslim? Shia, some Shia declare, followers of Shia, declare Sunnis as kafir, Sunnis declare Shia as kafir, whose Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, even one depth, don't give the fatwa of takfir to the one who says, who is a Muslim, say La ilaha illa Muhammad Rasulullah. And if you do that, you yourself become a kafir. You know, we only care about Allah and the Holy Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we Ahmadi Muslims. Yes, we are declared as kafir. I have one question. The Holy Prophet said among 73 sects, there will be one sect, which will be the one, which will be the Jama'ah. Or according even the narrations, according to Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu, Hazrat Ali, which he said is Tariq al-Ahmadiyya. Who I go in depth. He also mentioned that Judaism was divided in 72 sects. All 72 believed in Allah, in Musa and Torah. Or Allah, Moses and the Bible. Only one group among them believed that Jesus, the son of Mary, was that Messiah who has been prophesied in the Bible. Now we believe in Allah, Muhammad, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and Quran. The same, 72 groups turned against us in 74, very clear. And it was in the news, I can tell you in the newspaper, 72, there was never unanimously, they agreed, all of them together, that Ahmadiyyat is out of pale of Islam. I tell you moreover, in reality, we are very proud because Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam prophecy has been fulfilled that we will be declared as kafirs, not by Allah, not by Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, but by certain religious scholars who are devoid of the real knowledge of the Holy Quran. This is what we believe. Then the question, why do you call yourself Muslim? I call myself Muslim because, very simple, because Allah and Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam call us Muslims. Then we do not care if the world calls us kafir. Has Jesus not been declared as kafir? Has Musa not been declared as kafir? Has Ibrahim not by his nations declared as kafir? Any prophet has been raised has been declared as kafir. Now let's go, let's continue. And very may God bless you with these questions, are very interesting questions. Now we go in depth. This Mahdi and Messiah, someone mentioned, Muhammad also mentioned the Mahdi and the Messiah. You know, I want to read something from the Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmed, peace be upon him. He explained the difference between Mahdi and the Messiah. He says, in my capacity of Jesus, the Messiah, it's my function to restrain the Muslims from wild attacks and bloodshed. The ahadith or narrations set forth clearly that when the Messiah comes back to the world, he will put an end to all religious wars. This is now being done. In my capacity as Al-Mahdi, Muhammad the Mahdi, it's my function to establish the unity of God with heavenly signs. For our Lord and Master, the Holy Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, has established the majesty and power and might of God in the hearts of the idolaters of Arabia through heavenly signs. I have been helped by the Holy Spirit in the same manner. This means Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in Ibn Majah, we read, La Mahdiyu wa la Mahdiyu illa Isa. There is no Mahdi except Isa. Then we read again in Bukhari, Qala Rasulullah, the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, peace be upon him, said, كيف أنتم إذا نزل ابن مريم فيكم وإمامكم منكم. How will be your state be when Jesus will descend while he will be the imam among you? How beautiful. Now the phenomena of Imam Mahdi has been mentioned in the Quran in Surah Al-Anbiya. It says وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقٍ. We give to Ibrahim Ishaq, Isaac, wa Yaqub, Nafila. And we gave him Jacob, the prophet, as his grandson. Nafila means also grandson here. Wa kullan ja'alna salihin. And all of them we made, I just translate in my own words, as righteous. وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَئِمَّا يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا. We made them imams, أَئِمَّا, imams, who are guided by our command. Imam Mahdi means imam appointed by God. You see, imam, very interesting, أَئِمَّا يَهْدُونَ, an imam appointed by God or guided by God. أَئِمَّا يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا. That means they are imams guided by God's command. That means a prophet is the imam guided by Allah. That is why Muhammad said, when Jesus will come, remember Jesus is not that he died. I will give you so many proofs of this later. There is no Jesus, and there will be no Mahdi except Jesus. Jesus will be the Mahdi, Mahdi will be the Jesus. How beautifully explained. That is why Ahmad bin Hanbal, in Hadith, he says, about Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, says in one of the narrations, you find it in Musnad, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يوشك من عاش منكم أن يلقى عيسى بن مريم إماما مهديا. عيسى will be the himself the imam. Let's continue now about this topic. It's a very important topic. Now, as I explained, we as Ahmadis believe in ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله ورسول الله وخاتم النبيين وكان الله بكل شيء عليما. Muhammad is not the father of any of you men, but certainly he's the messenger of Allah and he's the seal of the prophets. I do not even want to go in depth about this at the moment. You know, the khatam has been used in so many connotations. There is the word khatam shu'ara in Arabic, which doesn't mean the last sha'ir, the last poet, means the best among the poets, who excelled in his field of poetry, or in the field of poetry. Like Muhammad also mentioned clearly that he's the khatam nabiyin, and that Ali radiallahu anhu is the khatam al-awliya. He's the seal of the awliya. And that was true, he was the seal of awliya. He became the khalifa of his time. Now, there is word like Khatm al-Muhajirin, which means among those who make the hijrah, the migration, that person was the best among them, excelled others. Now, as I just want to read only this thing. The Prophet Messiah said, in order, he said, I do not claim any prophethood that is putting to halt, stopped or barred by the Holy Quran. All I claim is that in one aspect, I am a follower of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and in other, through following Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, through his grace, the grace of prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I am a prophet. In my case, prophethood means that I am frequently honored with converse with God. And it is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam who mentioned him in Sahih Muslim. Nabiullah, 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 Nabiullah. He mentioned him four times as Nabiullah. The answer is simple. Nabuwa is continuously after Muhammad, continues, because Allah still speaks. The proof that Allah spoke in the past can only be proven if Allah still speaks. We believe that Allah speaks, not that we are finding in books that Allah spoke to certain people, because Allah is still speaking to the people. The proof that Allah still speaks, the proof that Allah still speaks can only be proven, not through books, that God spoke in the past, can only be proven if Allah still speaks. Now, someone is asking me here, what is the difference between Ahmadis and non-Ahmadis? And the difference, and what is the proof of Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad's truthfulness in his claim of being the Prophet's Messiah? May Allah bless the one who asked me these questions, because there are many episodes coming, and I just want to mention here, the truthfulness, we go into depth about this, in relation to this subject. I'm now, at the moment, speaking about the prophecies and about the need of that time. one of the proofs that the promised Messiah is true is the need. Let's go first. There are many proofs, but I'm going step by step to explain this. One of them is the need of time. The Bible mentions very clear, many shall run to and from, and knowledge shall be increased. There, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا. The Quran says the earth will be shaken, and anything which is in the earth will be brought, all the bill will be brought forward, and the humankind will be perplexed and say, what is happening? What's going on? Quran says, إِذَا الْحُوحُشُ حُشِرَتْ. When all the animals, people will make an end to animals, all the animals will be brought together. وَإِذَا الْوُحُوشُ حُشِرَتْ وَإِذَا النُّفُوسُ زُوِّجَتْ. You see all the nations, people will merge into each other. The world will come like a global village. إِذَا الصُّحُفُ نُشِرَتْ. You will find publication books spread all over the world. Then he said, إِذَا also one other is إِذَا الْعِشَارُ عُطِلَتْ. He said, when the she camel will be left, يَتْرُكُ الْقِلَاسْ فَلَا يُسَعَ عَلَيْهَا. And the people will leave. People will leave the camel as a transport, and there will be new kind of transport, and I will explain that later. And if you use your mind and think in depth, you find that the Holy Prophet said about the Dajjal, the Antichrist. He said he will have a donkey, you know, will go all over the world, and he said it has a moon on its forehead. People will enter its belly, and it will go by fire, and all of these things. Something will come instead of a donkey, instead of a camel, but it will be run by, you know, it will run by fire, and it will have a moon in front of it. You think, don't you think it can be? I don't want to go into this depth. The steam train, the locomotive. Don't you? The 19th century, that was the beginning, that was the age, the start, initial stage of the 7th century, 7th millennium, where in reality the Bible made that prophecy. That will be the 7th day, the battle which will take place, the 7th, between Michael, angel Michael, and Satan. That is the Holy Quran, Surah Fatiha. صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ. Those who Allah blessed with His favors, not those who incurred His displeasure, nor those who went astray and denied God. Which means very clearly, the industrial revolution took place. We find even the war between China and England, 1842. Then we find the Indian Mutiny, England, all over the world, Indian Mutiny, 1857. All these wars at that time, Franco-Prussian War, Russian-Turkey War, a war between Turkey and Greece, invasion of China by great powers, the War of 1812, Canada, USA against Canada and Britain, and the Industrial Revolution took place in UK, and then to Belgium, and then other countries in the world. The whole technical revolution took place. And scientific revolution took place. A doctrinal revolution took place. Communism, capitalism, the whole world changed. The people was drowned into, you know, went drowned into materialism. Christianity, Muhammad Sassman said, the Romans will be all over the world, which Christians will be all over the world. The Muslims will lose their power in 1924, the end of the Ottoman Empire. No caliphate after that. According, of course, we believe caliphate. What's that? Don't you think people got up false prophets as Jesus? There will be so many who will claim in His name that they are the Messiah, the Mahdi of Sudan, the Mahdi in Sudan, Alexander Dawi, and will continue. So many others who claimed. The need. It was the need of time. It was Muslims, hundred thousands of Muslims, especially if we look to India, hundred thousands of them became Christians, entered Christianity. The Christians, there was a plan, the Christianity should be spread to its missionaries all over the world. That was the time when only from the aspect of need of time that God sent the Messiah. Moreover, God says, I will go, that a false prophet should be, will not survive. He will be ended by God himself, because he will be create, if he will survive, he will create chaos. And the problem is Messiah Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmed survived. Even in 1905, 3 years before his death, he already wrote the book, The Will, that his end is near, and that he, in reality, fulfilled that mission, completed his mission. And that after him, Islam will be spread all over the world by his successors. The second manifestation, Caliphate. Are you Sunni or Shia? I'm telling you, there is one Islam which is brought by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are the followers of the person who claimed to be the Messiah, and the Mahdi, Hadrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmed. In this case, we consider ourselves Ahmadi Muslims. Ahmadi Muslims are the two Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Not, we are not only following the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are the Jama'ah. We are led by one. We are one body. We are a Jama'ah, and a Jama'ah is in Quran only established by through prophethood. Thumma, as Holy Prophet Muhammad has mentioned, thumma takun khilafa ala minhaj an-nabuwah. Then that caliphate, you know, that caliphate based on the precepts or on pattern of prophethood will return. And we are now in the time of fifth caliph. That means we are Ahlus Sunnah Jama'ah. I am not a Shia. I am not a Sunni. I am a follower. I am a follower of the true Islam, which I believe has been brought exactly and brought back 1300 years back, and the pure Islam brought by Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmed alayhi salatu wasalam wa alayhi salam. Now, there are other questions, and let me first, before answering all these questions, I will continue about the just because the problems Messiah mentioned also very clear. The death of Jesus, in his death, we're not in, you know, Jesus prophet like all other prophets, he was a great prophet. But why do we mention it? He said death of Jesus, in death of Jesus lies the revival of Islam. Muslims are now humiliated, economically, politically, spiritually divided. Look what's going on in the Arab world. I'm myself an Arab. And we are waiting, people are waiting, Messiah has come. I give you the glad tidings, Messiah already came. In the time of Jesus, those who refused him are still waiting for the Messiah. In the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him, those people are waiting for him among the Jewish. Those who find some prophecies to be fulfilled in him, they accepted him and became Muslims. Though he rejected him, are still waiting for first the Messiah and the prophet who had been prophesied in the Bible, who had to appear. The Christians are still waiting for Jesus, the Son of Mary, to come down from the heavens. Everyone is waiting. And we are telling you, think, ponder, and pray. Look what I'm telling you. Allah the Almighty is a living God who still speaks, who shows his dream, through his own tools. He's communicating with people, dreams, visions. He has his own ways. Pray to Allah and say, I listen to this Periscope and the Facebook Live. And you know, there is one Arab who was telling us that Mirza Ghulam Ahmed, who is denied by all these religious scholars, some of religious scholars, better to say, or majority, and they consider them as kafir or kuffar. Oh Allah, is this person now true or not? Do you really think that the one who has been sent by Allah, it's Allah himself who will show you the truth? Is he right or not? لَوْ تَقَوَّلَ عَلَيْنَا بَعْدَ الْأَقَوِيلِ Allah says, if the Holy Prophet or any prophet lied, fabricated any word in my name, I would have destroyed him. Now, do you really think a false prophet is always destroyed and Jamaat Ahmadiyya is growing? All the opposition and all the persecution. And you say it's growing, growing, growing. Ahmadis have been persecuted. They migrated. And God sends them from Africa, from the Arab world, from England, from Europe, everywhere. 600,000 Ahmadis. You know, 600,000 people accepted Ahmadiyya in 1 year. I'm telling you. Let's go into, let's go again into depth. Now, some people say, no, about Jesus. No, he had special powers because he was someone who could create birds. He created by Allah's command birds. Let's see. Let's check this. Is this true or not? Let me read from Surah An-Nahl 20. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا تُسِرُّونَ وَمَا تُعْلِنُونَ وَالَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ لَا يَخْلُقُونَ شَيْئًا وَهُمْ يُخْلَقُونَ أموات غير أحياء وما يشعرون أيان يبعثون. And those on whom they call beside Allah, like those people who make Jesus as a god beside God, son of God or God or whatever, Allah says they do not create anything, but they are themselves created. They are not able to create anything. They, Allah themselves create them. They are dead. If you worship Jesus, Allah says Jesus is dead. Not living. And they even know not when they will be raised. Then Allah goes further. No, no. Jesus, it's not only this. He was Jesus by Allah's command he created. Allah says in the Holy Quran, قُلْ مَنَ رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. I say, who is the Lord of the heavens and the earth? قُلِ اللَّهِ. They will say, Allah. قُلْ أَفَتَخَذْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ لَا يَمْلِكُونَ لِأَنفُسِهِمْ نَفْعًا وَلَا ضَرًّا. قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الْأَعْمَى وَالْبَصِيرُ أَمْ هَلْ تَسْتَوِي الظُّلُمَاتُ وَالنُّورُ أَمْ جَعَلُوا. Now this point is very important, I will translate. أَمْ جَعَلُوا لِلَّهِ شُرَكَاءَ خَلَقُوا كَخَلْقِهِ فَتَشَابَهُ الْخَلْقُ عَلَيْهِمْ. And this is the important point. I read, or do they assign to Allah partners who have created the like of his creation, so that the two creations appear similar to him? This is very, very interesting, humoristic. Allah says, have they partners like Jesus beside God, and they think he created also something in my name or whatever, and that Jesus created birds, and Allah created birds, and my friend is sitting here in front of me. Can you now distinguish between the bird created by God or created by Jesus? You know, my dear brothers, we are Muslims. Islam is such a beautiful religion. It wants to unite mankind in love and brotherhood under the banner of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The one who does not want to accept Islam says, la ikraha fi din. There is no compulsion in religion. But at least, let's respect each other. Let's respect each other's religions. Let's not hurt each other's feelings. Let's be compassionate. And let's guarantee freedom of speech and freedom of religion. Now, this is the part I explain now about Jesus himself. And step by step in the next episodes, I will go into depth and explain the promised Messiah himself. As you see in the Bibles, the Messiah has come. His truthfulness. First, of course, I will show you 2, 3, 4, 5 verses of the death of Jesus. Then the truthfulness of the Messiah himself, and that he is the solution for the crisis in which we are now in the world. May God bless you, and see you. I think we still have 1 minute, as I see. And I will try still to answer one question After all the evidence, why don't Sunni and Shia join Ahmadiyya? Why don't they listen? My answer is, many Sunni and Shia are accepting. There are many good-hearted people among Sunnis and Shia when they read and they accept. Thousands and thousands are accepting us. And that is why we use now Periscope, Facebook Live, to give you the good news that the Messiah has come. Jazakumullah. May God bless you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you.